Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, this is your boy James, aka Hollywood J Black, live in the building once again. Back with another Synful Blaq Reacts. I got my mans, my main mans, Big MFN, Sinners in the building. How you doing today, sir?
And it's a Tuesday morning, I think, and I'm alive and kicking, and I need people to hit that subscribe button. If you don't like what you see while you're here,
yes, yeah. Normally we get these knocked out over the weekend and spread them out just in the back end process. Unless something drops immediately, then we get it to you immediately. Well, this has been a weird week for both of us, between COVID happening and COVID not happening and will it or won't it and shit. Shit's just been all fucked up. So by the time you get it's Tuesday morning. You guys are gonna get this Tuesday later on in your evening. Hopefully you enjoy it. Hopefully this brings you, you know, joy to make you want to hit that subscribe button. And if not, it's cool. I'm going to just slap the shit out you with a twisted tee. No big deal. All right. So, with that said, Eminem dropped a new track last week. You know how we do this. They drop a new track. Me and Ben Sin React. It's kind of the name of the game, right? So, this is Eminem with Higher. I'm excited. I heard many great things about this. So, let's stop the BS and we'll get right to it. Let's go.
Yeah, you know, I've been around for a while now. Not sure if I have much left to prove. Yeah, dude.
I love the beat.
I look at me now, I'm thinking, damn, how proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France. I look around, I see the fans, how they surround me in the stands. Probably could drown in a sea of hands. They're hollering, shame. Yelling it out to me, and that's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance. I've done it all, man, but in actuality, I haven't yet.
Where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Where am I supposed to go from here?
Okay, okay. All right, so.
Yeah, M's feeling himself on this one.
Oh, yeah, M's back on his shit. I think that chip, he's had a chip on his shoulder the last couple albums, and that chip has got less and less and less. And now he's on his shit now. Listen. I don't say it's a different type of Eminem, but it's still the lyrical content is still there. But some, like you said, it just feels like he's feeling himself this time around. You know what I'm saying?
One of those things. Everybody's out there telling him he don't belong in the rap game. He's not hip hop and all this shit. But I'm gonna ask each and every one of them. I'm gonna look him in the face right now. Who's done it better?
Exactly. There's a reason why this man's the king of hip hop. Like, I don't want to hear nothing else. Like, to me.
It's like you got LeBron, Tom Brady, they're the goats of their industry.
Yep.
Now he's Eminem. He's the goat of hip hop. It is what it is.
Exactly. 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 All right, let's keep this thing going. I'm feeling this track.
I know haters in this bitch. Well, toleration for the shit, but like medication, my dedication and the time it takes to do this shit reminds me of how an overcrowded hospital.
I feel like he's going through the 50 Cent aftermath training program.
I'm able to admit, yeah, but I'm still mentally stable. There's a three-legged table in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade this shit for the trailer with a hitch that it would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt. Now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous, can't extinguish this English language when it's lit. And I'm just berating you with it. It's shady till I'm 82. I spit this crazy, even Dre, he knows I'm a blow. Better get the handkerchief again.
So where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Go from here, okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is
jealous every time I think I hit my ceiling. I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Real quick before we get into that, I just want to say that I wish that the song was out when we had we can do custom music on NBA 2K. Not 2K, but WWE 2K, where we could install, you know, do our custom songs on the PlayStation 3. I wish this song was out. This would have been a perfect faction fucking theme music. But yeah, Eminem.
Hey, I apologize for what just happened. My whole setup just about fell over. So.
It happens. I mean, shit. Dude, this happened to me like 3 times in this whole time that me and you have been doing these shows. So you're allowed to do it once. It's okay. It's okay. Everybody gets one, okay? Everybody gets one.
We recorded this video right before the latest UFC fight. He released it, I think, the day of. And he told Dana White that he uses people. It's a little... He's got some beef with Dana White, so...
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, he's right. He's right to have beef with them. Dana White does use fighters when he needs them, and when he doesn't, throws them out, you know? He doesn't give the people that deserve a shot a shot. Dana White is slowly turning into Vince McMahon when he used to be the anti-Vince McMahon. You know what I'm saying? Like, first he used to be like, you want to fight? Fucking fight. Now he's like, you want to fight? Make some money for me, bitch. Oh, okay.
Well. Let's bring back a guy who doesn't have it in him no more.
Yes.
And promote him like he's the next fucking Messiah. And then he gets knocked out and then you're like, oh, that wasn't supposed to happen.
But you put him against the guy who's supposed to, who you declare your next big thing, right? And you wonder what the fuck is going on. This is never good. It's never, ever gone good. Anytime that they put a UFC fighter that's been gone for more than a year against another UFC fighter that is on the absolute fucking hot streak, it never ends well.
Then what happened to Ronda Rousey?
Yep, exactly. Dana White never gonna learn. It is what it is. All right, let's keep this thing going.
If we learn anything from watching 8 Mile is that when it comes to battle rap, don't come for Eminem. He will be the first to tell you that he treats the rap game the same way the world's best athletes treat their respective sports, with a 24/7 tenacity that only the elite are able to channel. He spent his entire life studying and training to be the best, but even with a life of preparation, will it be enough for his next battle? It's one thing to conquer your competition. It's another to conquer your demons. With us now to share his thoughts is Dana White, who knows a thing or two about marquee battles. Dana, thanks for being with us. How prepared can one be when going up against an opponent of this magnitude?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Listen, I'm a huge Eminem fan, but this is a tough one. This opponent is not someone you can prepare for. It's a tricky demon to conquer, even for someone as badass as Eminem. My prediction? Is disappointment for fans all over the world.
That's interesting. We are now joined by the man himself, Eminem. M, appreciate it. What's your response to what Dana just said?
I want to say, first of all, thank you for having me on. I think that people like you give people like me the fuel that they need to succeed in the first place. So I think that the best part about your opinion is that it doesn't matter. And if every fighter that you had listened to your opinion when you doubted them, you wouldn't have a f***ing league, so you're an a**hole, and I'm out.
Well, he definitely sounds ready. In any case, it should be a battle for the ages. Thank you, Dana, and best of luck to you, Eminem.
My lord. First, that was like the greatest interlude in between a song in the history of ever.
Well, no, that was the actual interview for SportsCenter.
That is insane. He said... So you know what? Fuck you, and I'm out.
But he said facts, though. You know, Dana White is not the same Dana White we saw 5 years ago.
I know, it's Dana McMahon, nigga. That's what it is, Dana McMahon. But anyways, that's not the point. You know what? This makes me really clamor for having rap battles on ESPN now. That's because that's kind of... Like, I want to hear some commentary from rappers and people in the sports world commenting on hip-hop battles. I want to see, like, I want to see Stephen A. Smith comment on Loaded Lux versus somebody, you know what I'm saying? You know what time it is? It's about that time. Oh.
I want Scott Van Pelt doing the play-by-play. That's right.
He just roasted him, completely sent him into oblivion. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. He is out of here. Oh.
fucking Chris Vernon. He's fumbling, been stumbling with words.
I didn't understand a word he said. He made Lil Uzi Vert sound listenable. God damn. Oh, my bad.
All right, let's get this done.
Now, what am I going to do? Can't nothing hold me, I'm on the loose. Born a winner, never so hard to lose. I can do it even when I'm trying to. With my record flop, I still go through the roof. This atmosphere is for a chosen few who was on their grind making money moves. And you ain't going to get there if you water down. You got to take shots, check 100 proof.
Been in survival mode. Since a 5-year-old, it was I alone. Since my trike was stole's viral notebook and microphone. But looking back, how bad it was then. If it hadn't have been for the pad and the pin addict, mom and dad beat dad, I wouldn't have had the savage within. Having to win every single battle I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously, I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMD must have had teaching degrees. Learned to defeat enemies with the ink. Thinking of these rhymes would be as easy as E. And graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. To my last breath, these my lungs. I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. The east side slums, gotta remind them. I'll take a foe out like feet by thumb. You see my finger, you see my thumb. You see my fist for a least pipe. I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the weed I want. With this beat I brung for the beef I've come. But you better bring it if you want to reply from. For you to be lyrically inclined,
I just find it hilarious that Shady is Shady. I think
I'm out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my ceiling higher. Cause
where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea.
I like that part.
I think I hit my ceiling. I go higher than I've ever fucking been. To go from here, okay. No, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Okay.
So the fight was between Eminem, Marshall, and Shane.
Yes. And that's how you combine the two and you get Eminem. Shady has no face. Shady's just Shady, okay? Shady's transition time and space. He is now the Void from Destiny 2, ladies and gentlemen. He is actually Shady. You cannot see his face. He is an omnipotent being now. He is, yeah. All jokes aside, ladies and gentlemen, that was an interesting video. I have actually, this is the first time in a long time I've been entertained by a video with the interlude in the middle of it. I think 50 Cent had one maybe way back in the day. And the videos like this is what music videos used to be like. You know what I'm saying? Where you just have some fun in the middle of it, put a little story to it, you know what I'm saying? And I think that we've lost that art with music videos in hip-hop. It's supposed to be over the top, you know? And then...
Well, we've lost a lot of things when it comes to hip-hop.
Coherent first verses, of all, decent beats.
First of all, oh shit, we lost fucking real lyricists. second of all, the only part of the song that made me go, why is he doing this? Is when he had that little mumble shit right at the beginning of the third verse.
Yeah.
But then he picked it up with his fucking rapid fire flow that just murdered the whole fucking song. Man, so.
Well, it makes sense though, because I felt like it was like people talking shit. So I felt like it was somebody else that, I think it wasn't M doing it. It was somebody else doing it. I don't know who it was.
It sounded like Lil Uzi or even fucking Homeboy Juice WRLD. That's the sound I got from it. But
it was meant to be somebody talking shit about him, and like the new age people talking shit about him, and new age feeds off that mumble rap. You know what I'm saying? And so that's kind of what the deal was. It was his, and then he has his response to it, which I like. It's a nice little touch, nice little sprinkle. You know what I'm saying? It's that's vintage Eminem, as Michael Cole would say.
And Eminem continues to be on the top of his game. Everything he puts out, it's not fair what he does.
It's not fair. It's not fair to the rest of the industry. Like I said, it's Eminem, Tech N9ne, Ritz, Jelly Roll, Tom McDonald. Those are the guys that are in hip hop. Shady's even not. You know, Shady's not even with Aftermath no more. Shady's with Interscope, so they have the distribution deal with Interscope. But past that. So, like Shady's the king of mainstream because he has to deal with Interscope. If he didn't have to deal with Interscope, you can consider him an independent artist. But then you have...
The way he does... What he does, though, is... I'm sure you noticed he has free reign of what he does with Interscope.
Well, that's the thing. So he has no more Aftermath to deal with.
He doesn't even talk about an album coming out. He just drops that shit. He's like, here you go.
Yeah. Because what are they going to do? Not let Eminem come out with an album and go platinum? Nah. You're like, you know what, Eminem? No, we don't need you to sell records to make us money. No, we don't need the streams. We don't need it, okay? We don't need you to go quadruple platinum in the stream world, okay? It's just we don't need it. Yeah. Hey, but you know Birdman did that to Lil Wayne, so I guess it is possible. All right, so that's a replay for me. I love the song. I love the beat. I love how Eminem back again producing beats again. You know what I'm saying? Some hot shit, some anthems. He's out there doing anthems again. Goddamn.
He said, I think on one of the songs that we did prior, that his temper tantrum turned into an anthem.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes. All right. So with that said, Big Sin, is there anything you'd like to tell the congregation before we bounce up out of here?
If you're over on YouTube, like, comment, and subscribe, ring that bell so you know more Synful Blaq reacts dropped. If you're on Facebook, like and follow, or let us know in the comments below what you want us to react to. We got you.
All right. Now, Big Sin's going to think I'm having an epileptic seizure by the time he sees this video and uploads it to YouTube because he can't see me now. But it's okay. He loves me nonetheless. So until next time, that's my man, Big Sin. See, I got it right this time. I'm your boy, Hollywood J. Blaq. This is Synful Blaq Reacts, and we out this thing. Deuces. Or something, or deuces.